is CBS News on the Hour, sponsored by O'Reilly Auto Parts.
I'm Stacey Lynn. Iran is looking to punish Israel for a strike on its consulate in Syria that killed several of its top generals. A retaliatory attack could be imminent. How's the White House responding? Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre.
Obviously, we've seen the threats coming from Iran, and so we have made ourselves very clear where we stand in supporting Israel's security. That is ironclad. That does not change. I'm just not going to get into details about our operational procedures from here.
Another round of student loan forgiveness is coming. CBS's Bo Erickson says more than $7 billion more will be canceled.
In total, the Biden administration has canceled $153 billion of student loan debt for more than 4 million Americans. And senior administration officials defended the legal basis of these programs as a lawsuit was recently filed by several Republican attorneys general throughout the country.
House Speaker Johnson's heading to Florida today to meet with former President Trump. The two will make remarks on election security. CBS's Robert Costa.
By standing with Trump, Johnson's allies tell me behind the scenes they believe he will solidify his own political standing.
So much rain in such a short time caused a whole lot of problems.
Widespread flooding caused by torrential rain led to high water rescues in the hills of eastern Kentucky and western Pennsylvania, as well as the mountains of West Virginia. Craig Deesher lives in drenched Oakdale, Pennsylvania, outside Pittsburgh.
There was a family, an older lady that was in there, and it was about to reach into her first floor, but she was afraid to even come out. So it was flooding so bad and the water was moving so fast.
There was also extensive flooding in and around Tallahassee, Florida. Jim Crisula, CBS News.
The former interpreter for Shohei Ohtani is expected in court today, charged with allegedly stealing millions of dollars of the baseball star's money to pay off gambling debts. CBS's Adam Yamaguchi is following the story in Los Angeles.
Ipe Mizuhara, according to the U.S. attorney, found himself in very, very deep. And so at some point, he began to funnel money from Shohei Ohtani's account to pay off the bookie.
He faces years in prison. Lots of reaction pouring into the death of O.J. Simpson. Cato Kaelin, his famed house guest, spoke out in a video he posted to social media.
I wish to express my love and compassion to the Goldmans, to Fred and to Kim, to the family of the beautiful Nicole Brown Simpson. May we always cherish her memories.
Cato was one of the witnesses in what's been called the trial of the century. Ahead of the open on Wall Street, Dow futures rise, S&P has slipped. This is CBS News.
Think O'Reilly Auto Parts for all your car care needs. Get the parts and service you need fast from the professional parts people at O'Reilly Auto Parts.
eBay Motors is here for the ride. Go ahead, feel your engine. Admire that perfectly installed exhaust. Your vehicle's moving along this freeway like it was made from fresh installs and a whole lot of love. With eBay Motors, you get over 122 million parts to keep it running. And with eBay Guaranteed Fit, they'll be the perfect fit every time. Plus at these prices, well, we're burning rubber, not cash. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only. Exclusions apply.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential, but finding those people can be a major hassle. Unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze. ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies candidates with the right skills, sends you great matches, then you can easily invite them to apply. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. See for yourself. Go to ZipRecruiter.com/free to try ZipRecruiter for free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free.
President Biden will talk about racial justice today.
The keynote address will be delivered by President Biden to the National Action Network Conference hosted by the Reverend Al Sharpton. The Biden campaign says the president will discuss his accomplishments and the policies enacted to address racial inequality. Kenesha Grant with Howard University.
This is a smart plan by President Biden, making sure that he speaks to the constituent groups that he needs to speak to in the black community.
Polls show a softening of black voter preferences for Biden. Jennifer Kuiper, CBS News.
Well, after their first Netflix show, Harry and Meghan, was watched by more than 81 million households, they've got two new projects in the works. Meghan will star in what sounds like a Martha Stewart-y lifestyle show featuring cooking, gardening, and entertaining. The second show will focus on one of Harry's favorite sports, polo. It's currently filming at the U.S. Open Polo Championship in Wellington, Florida. Stacey Lynn, CBS News.
Why do so many dogs suffer from weight issues, skin problems, messy poops, and low energy? It could be the popular dog food you put in their bowl each day.
Cody was sleeping a lot, wasn't playing.
She was very lethargic and not moving around.
Dry kibble just wasn't cutting it.
That's why, after more than 45 years of experience of helping dogs make complete health turnarounds, veterinarian Dr. Marty created Nature's Blend. It's a freeze-dried raw dog food made with wholesome ingredients like premium meats, seeds, vegetables, and fruit. And once dog parents switch their pups to Nature's Blend, the results can be astounding.
She's got her energy back. She's running around like she did like 5 years ago.
Miraculously, she's just feeling all around better. She's like a new dog. Thank you, Dr. Marty.
Get your dog started today and save up to 54% off Nature's Blend. Plus, receive a free pack of our best-selling beef liver dog treats. Go to drmartypets.com/good or text good to 511-511. Text good to 511-511. All dogs are unique. Your dog's results can and will vary. Message and data rates.
Are you one of thousands of men suffering from BPH, also known as enlarged prostate? This common condition often makes it difficult to urinate and can cause the bladder to weaken over time. Sleep and even sexual health may also be impacted. TJ Regional Health is now offering the most advanced, minimally invasive surgical treatment for BPH called Aquablation. Aquablation provides long-lasting relief without unwanted side effects. For more information, please visit tjregionalhealth.org/aquablation.
Introducing the Glasgow EPB customer payment portal and mobile app. With our new sleek and user-friendly payment portal, managing your Glasgow EPB services has never been easier. And if you need to make a payment on the go, our new mobile app lets you pay your bills with just a few taps. The Glasgow EPB customer payment portal and mobile app, because managing your Glasgow EPB services should be as simple as flipping a switch. Visit glasgowepb.com/billpay today to sign up and download the app.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome to Good Morning Live on WCLU 103.1 and AM 1490. Your home for local sports, news, information, and a whole lot of fun. Live from our studios in downtown Glasgow, it's Good Morning Live.
Well, folks, we have made it to Friday. Good Morning Live here at WCLU. James Coates with you. Matthew Clark going to be joining me here shortly. Well, throughout the morning. So, 6:07, chilly outside too, 49 degrees. Our high today only reaching 59. It's going to be very windy today. We'll talk about that here in just a little bit. Also, all kinds of local news headed your way this hour. We want to jump right into our birthdays today and the weekend too. So, we have several. Let's jump in. April 12th, happy birthday to Lorraine Jones, top of the list today. Francis Lee, Teresa White is 52. John Michael Newberry, happy birthday. Brenda Pierce, also Brenda Walker Russell, 63. Mandy Elmore, Eric Bragg, and Loretta Davis all celebrate today on this Friday. A couple of anniversaries, too. We have Steve and Nikki Garman, 21 years. Congratulations. And Lillian and Evelyn Russell, 66 years. That's a long time. Happy anniversary to you folks today. We'll go ahead and jump right into Saturday's birthday list. We have Ralph Riley, Glenda Gardner for Saturday the 13th. We have Sandra Matthews. Luke Pitcock celebrates tomorrow. Heather Wyatt Parsley, Brandy Davis, Roy London, and Jack Turner. So congratulations to you folks celebrating tomorrow. And then we're going to end the weekend on Sunday, April 14th, with Charles Tony Hayes, Carol Flynn, Valerie Stokes, Calvin Benjamin, Martha Walden Neal, William Myatt. Also, big happy birthday to Wanda Scott, Betty Richardson, Jeremy Alexander, and Mary Coffey. That's grandmother and grandson celebrating Sunday. Ellery Hayes and also Addison Bell Allen all celebrate Sunday. And one anniversary, that's Haley and Jeremy Frazier on Sunday. So congratulations to you folks if you're celebrating today or over the weekend. Now, the WCLU Good as Gold Person of the Day today is Marcia Latira, and I hope we're saying that name right today. She volunteers at the South Central Kentucky Cultural Center. She's been picked as our Good as Gold Person of the Day and the fifth name. that goes in the hat for this morning's drawing just before 8 o'clock. Our big little taste of Texas drawing. Looking forward to it. $20 toward a great meal there at a little taste of Texas. 651-9149, 800-956-1023. Get your birthday in this morning, your wedding anniversary, and we'll give you a big shout out throughout the entire day. And you'll have a shot at winning that Dairy Queen cake a little later on, and the Greer's Rosebud Vase as well. You can also visit our website and submit right there at WCLUradio.com and nominate someone that you love and respect to be a Good as Gold Person of the Day. It's 6:10. Let's check your weather forecast and then local news straight ahead. A few showers possible today at 40%. A breezy day with a high near 60. West winds 11 to 16. They could kick up as high today as 34 miles per hour. Tonight clear and quite chilly as we dip down to 40 with winds reaching near 22. Sunshine beautiful on Saturday to kick off the weekend. High of 71 with a west wind at 10. Saturday night clear 56. Mostly sunny Sunday to wrap up the weekend. High of 77 with those winds continuing southwest 13 to 18 gusting near 26 miles per hour on Sunday. Sunday night clear in 60. Monday mostly sunny. High of 81. Monday night mostly cloudy 62. And partly sunny, breezy again on Tuesday with a high of 79. Looking ahead to next Wednesday, 40% chance of rain and maybe a thunder shower back in the area. Partly sunny, breezy, high near 80. Again today, 40% chance that you'll see a shower, maybe an isolated thunderstorm. Today's high near 60 with wind gusts today near 34 miles per hour. 73% humidity right now. Pressure 29.84. Right there on your screen, too, if you're watching us this morning. Winds are at 12 miles per hour. Precipitation in the last 24, I'm showing about 0.45. Visibility 15 miles. Sunrise on the way at 6:12. That's like 10 seconds from right now or so. Sunset tonight 7:16. Currently chilly outside, 49 degrees. The big threat today, I guess, the wind gusting near 34 miles per hour and 22 miles an hour tonight. So please be careful out there. Local news straight ahead. WCLU Radio brings you Traveling the Bluegrass. Traveling the Bluegrass is dedicated to sharing the stories of agriculture and simple life in Kentucky. Host Alan Watt shares stories from Pikeville to Paducah with a focus on agriculture and what makes Kentucky a wonderful place to live. Traveling the Bluegrass, weekday mornings at 5:15 on WCLU. Visit youragedge.com.
Your source for local for more than 30 years. This is WCLU Local News.
For WCLU Local News, I'm Wes Royce reporting. In a poignant tribute to the legacy of the late Judge Tom Emberton, the Metcalf County Judicial Center is set to undergo a significant transformation. Not only will the center be renamed to the Tom Emberton Judicial Center, but a statue in the late judge's likeness will be constructed in front of the center to greet guests and residents of the small town. Judge Emberton, a revered figure in Metcalf County's legal landscape, left an indelible mark on the community through his unwavering commitment to justice and tireless advocacy for the rights of its citizens. Tommy Garrett, Metcalf County Clerk, knew the judge personally, as he explains.
Of course, Judge Emberton was a personal friend of mine all my life. His wife was my sixth grade teacher. Judge was just a good man, and nobody in Metcalf County ever said a bad word about him. He used to live by my great-grandfather, and my great-grandfather would be milking, and Judge Emberton would come down there, and he would tell him stories. And so when Judge Emberton went to the military, he corresponded with my grandfather, my great-grandfather. And so anyway, then Judge and I became really, really close friends.
The decision to rename the center comes as a fitting tribute to Judge Emberton's enduring legacy. Garrett, a retired Kentucky State Police trooper, had a first-hand experience with the judge professionally. This, combined with their personal attachments, led to Garrett making the call to State Representative Jason Nemus to begin the process of immortalizing the judge.
Well, I contacted Jason Nemus, and I, Representative Nemus, and Amy Neighbors, our representative, were just discussing it. And Jason really wanted to name this the Judge Emberton Courthouse. And so Representative Neighbors' husband, Jason, and I have started a project that we're going to build a They're going to put a statue of Judge Emerton out in front of the courthouse.
Construction of the statue is slated to begin in October, with local artist Russell Faxon heading the project. As preparations for the statue's construction get underway, residents of Metcalf County eagerly anticipate the opportunity to honor Judge Tom Emberton and celebrate his enduring legacy of service and dedication. Garrett, as a final thought to his late friend and pillar of the community, said,
"There's never been a more distinguished person from Metcalf County than Tom Emberton, in my opinion."
Metcalf Fiscal Court met yesterday morning. Gage Wilson has the details.
The Metcalf Fiscal Court convened yesterday for a heated discussion surrounding the renewal of the city's CAECO insurance policy, sparking discontent among many county employees. The deliberations, which highlighted diverging opinions among court members, underscored the challenges of balancing fiscal responsibility with the welfare of county workers. The CAECO insurance policy, a staple benefit for county employees, has come under scrutiny among the county employees with concerns over coverage adequacy. As the court weighed the pros and cons of renewing the policy, tensions ran high among county workers who voiced their dissatisfaction with the current insurance arrangement. The discourse between County Treasurer Paige Edwards and a dissatisfied county employee summed up the state of the discussion.
"I'd like to see you check in some more company or something, but what I've got is not worth 15 cents. Health insurance.
Well, we got it through CAECO, and you made us getting out of the health insurance business.
There's a lot more companies out there than CAECO, and I believe we can get a whole lot better insurance for less money. Now, there's a lot more employees that's not happy with it either, but maybe it's not here."
Judge Executive Larry Wilson proposed that a special called meeting inviting local insurance groups to speak to the county and public directly would be the best course of action to the agreement of the magistrates. The meeting date has not been set as of now, but court members will have to decide to stay with CAECO or swap to a different company before the budget approval in June. With WCLU Radio, I'm Gage Wilson.
Metcalf County Middle School is proud to announce 7 students have been selected for the 2024 Rogers Explorers program. The Rogers Explorers program is an intensive 3-day, 2-night program focused on cultivating skills in leadership, technology, math, science, and community service. The following 8th grade students received invitations, 5 as explorers and 2 as alternates: Morgan Avery, Lydia Bennett, Haley Gilliam, Cade Huffman, Leah Kerr, Mackenzie Grissom, and Haley Neal. Metcalf County Middle School Principal Jenny Stotts Lundy said, "I am thrilled to congratulate these exceptional students on their selection for the Rogers Explorers program. This achievement is a testament to their dedication, talent, and potential to make a positive impact in our community." Rogers Explorers is developed, coordinated, and supervised by the Center for Rural Development in partnership with the University of the Cumberlands, Lindsey Wilson College, Eastern Kentucky University, Morehead State University, University of Pikeville, and Union College. Activities are both educational and fun. Students participate in practical college courses, fine-tune leadership skills, and develop a network of friends and resources throughout Southern and Eastern Kentucky regions. In his final segment from the recent Barron River Area Development District Summit, Gage Wilson covers what was discussed about housing issues in the region.
Amidst the picturesque backdrop of the Cave Area Convention Center, the Regional Barron River Area Development District, or BRAD, Summit delved into critical discussions surrounding housing issues plaguing the region. A breakout session dedicated to exploring the challenges and opportunities in the realm of housing garnered significant attention from attendees eager to address pressing concerns affecting communities across the district. Led by Patrick Bowen, president of Bowen National Research, the group was educated on affordable housing shortages to infrastructure deficiencies and zoning regulations. Kevin Maya, director of the Joint City-County Planning Commission, had a keen interest in this session and explained to WCLU what steps the Planning Commission is researching to help combat prohibitive housing costs.
"The Planning Commission for our community has taken some initiative steps. We're obviously bound by what the community, the legislative bodies want, and we've looked at alternative measures for development, whether it being the manufactured modular homes like they spoke about, but also those non-traditional structures that you might not think about, such as tiny homes, what is an actual tiny home, and those that are non-traditional structures, shipping containers, things of that nature. So we've started taking a look at some of that stuff."
While the idea of tiny homes or modular homes may sound like a hodgepodge solution to a dire need, Myatt spoke on the regulations and planning that would go into the commission's role in the construction of such structures.
"The building code still comes into play for those things that still have to happen, but it's our responsibility to try to see if we can get close to meeting that housing need."
Communities in the area are not powerless, though. By becoming more involved in local government and planning endeavors, residents can pressure local governmental bodies to make the necessary steps to bring in more housing options by supporting infrastructure development, as Maya explains.
Some of the things that our local legislative bodies can do is, you know, get involved with infrastructure, provide the necessary water, sewer lines, electric lines, have those things pre-built so that your developers are reducing their costs, and hopefully we'll pass that on to whoever they're selling it to or renting to, and that kind of situation. Okay.
This is the final part in a series where WCLU went into a deep dive on all of the activities and educational materials that the Brad Summit had gone through. With WCLU Radio, I'm Gage Wilson.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential, but finding those people can be a major hassle. Unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze. ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies candidates with the right skills, sends you great matches, then you can easily invite them to apply. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. See for yourself. Go to ZipRecruiter.com/free to try ZipRecruiter for free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free.
In more local news at this hour, once seen only as a game for playtime, video games are now considered esports. Gage Wilson met with a Caverna Middle School student who is already seeing success as an esports athlete.
In a groundbreaking achievement, a senior from Caverna High School has soared to the top. Diego Ochoa quenched first in the KHSAA Esports Madden NFL 24 Solos. For Ochoa, this victory is a culmination of dedication, perseverance, and skill. Competing against peers across the state, he demonstrated exceptional prowess, navigating complex strategies and executing precise maneuvers with finesse, as was made evident as he explains the final moments of one of his matches.
Well, it was a tough game. It came out to the last second. I got a last second field goal.
Ochoa was joined by his teammate, Caverna Jr. Ladarius Wagner, who explained to WCLU why esports was different from more traditional athletics.
You don't have to be super athletic to play. You don't have to be, I don't know, like a super gamer. I mean, if you just want to try something out and get a new hobby, this is the perfect place to do it.
Beyond the thrill of victory, this achievement underscores the value of esports as a legitimate and respected extracurricular activity. Far from simply being a pastime, esports offer students a platform to hone valuable skills such as critical thinking, problem solving, communication, and teamwork. Skills that are essential not only in gaming, but also in academics and future careers. Ochoa was unsure what his future with esports may look like, as he and Wagner both were involved with the school's football team. Time was a major concern of theirs. Both young men, however, would like to see esports as a part of their academic career, as Wagner spoke on.
I would have liked to continue playing esports going into college if I had the extra time, but me also being an athlete, I don't know if I have extra time as I go to college.
The student's coach on the physical and virtual field, Tim Gower, elaborated on why esports at the school is not only beneficial to the social well-being of the team, but also the level playing field students can take advantage of.
That's one good thing about esports. It doesn't matter how big a school you are, if you're on the same, use the same equipment, same level. I mean, there's no extra stuff you can buy. You don't have to be the richest kid in the world. Everything's equal. And that's what's good about it. Just the best player wins.
The recognition of esports by KHSAA also signifies a broader shift in the perception of gaming. No longer confined to the realm of entertainment, esports is increasingly being embraced as a legitimate form of competition, deserving of the same recognition and support as traditional sports. With WCLU Radio, I'm Gage Wilson.
Barron County government will have 2 committee meetings this morning. The jail committee will meet at 8:45 a.m. at the Government Center 3rd floor conference room to discuss renewal of a contract for comprehensible correctional care. The transportation committee will meet in the same location just after at 9:30 a.m. Items on the agenda include open materials and supplies bids, open truck bids, open wind school LWF replacement bids, private roads and name signs, fuel tanks, truck repair bill, road department renovations bid, and other business.
For more local news and information, remember to turn to your home for local on the web, WCLUradio.com. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and X. And remember to hit the subscribe button on YouTube for our latest live streams of local sports and videos. For WCLU Local News, I'm Wes Royce reporting.
For over 25 years, Window World has provided quality products for homeowners around the country. Every window we sell is custom made for optimal energy efficiency and superior durability. Plus, a vinyl finish means they will never need painting. Just like our windows, entry doors from Window World are made to last, featuring a durable composite frame that will never rot. When it comes time to replace your windows or doors, trust Window World. Call 270-780-9600. Simply the best for me.
This is the Kentucky News Network.
Governor Andy Beshear is defending dozens of vetoes made this legislative session.
Among them was House Bill 5, the Safer Kentucky Act, which increases penalties for violent offenders.
This bill has a number of good sections, but I do believe it was cruel to put some of these sections that would have received unanimous approval with others that individuals knew would have been controversial.
A bill giving the General Assembly the final say on what's displayed in the Capitol Rotunda was also vetoed. While the sponsor says it's not related, that bill was crafted following the removal of the Jefferson Davis statue.
And I'm proud that we took the Jefferson Davis statue out. And I'll never apologize for that, even if language like this comes in.
Beshear says he vetoed 27 bills this legislative session. I'm Haley Hansen.
Republicans have supermajority and are expected to override Beshear's vetoes. Hall of Fame horse trainer Wayne Lucas is being honored with the Lifetime Achievement Award from the Kentucky Derby Museum. It is the first ever Lifetime Achievement Award presented by the Derby Museum. The dinner to honor Lucas was Thursday. Next month, he'll be the oldest trainer to have a horse in the Derby field. Good weather conditions have been critical in allowing fire crews to conduct controlled burns at the Land Between the Lakes National Recreation Area. The U.S. Forest Service says the burns remove ground clutter and allows the sun to reach the floor of the forest. That promotes new growth of trees. Kentucky crews were able to burn a record number, over 15,000 acres, in the LBL this winter. The Owensboro Regional Farmers Market is almost open for business. This farmers market returns from a winter break to welcome customers this Saturday at 1205 Triplett Street. Market officials say there are new vendors like the Herb Garden, Antoinette's Home Decor and Accessories, and Sly Designs. The farmers market is open Saturday from 8 a.m. until noon. I'm Lee Mowen.
This is the Kentucky News Network.
Celebrate the big horse race at the Paristown Derby Day Garden Party, presented by Woodford Reserve. At Paristown on Saturday, May 4th, wager and watch the races. Enjoy live music, cocktails, food, and more. VIP and general admission ticket options available. VIP tickets include box lunch, complimentary drinks, and private spaces. Tickets on sale now at Paristown.com. Don't miss Paristown's Derby Party for the people.
In search of the perfect cut for your lawn? Join the pursuit by choosing from a full line of Steel mowers. From gas and battery options to zero turns and push mowers, Steel offers a wide range of mowing solutions for homeowners and professionals. Right now, get 0% financing on your purchase with a Steel zero turn mower. Real Steel. Find yours at steelusa.com/mowers. Available at select dealers. Financing available on qualifying purchases.
Most people will hesitate before planning a funeral in advance.
The funeral? We'll arrange that when the time comes.
But there's a lot to be said for advance planning. For one thing, you have the peace of mind of knowing that your arrangements have all been made. You can consider the options when your mind is clear. And you'll have the relief of knowing that your loved one will be well cared for. A.F. Crow and Son Funeral Home, a celebration of love.
This is Dan Fouch, Managing Director and Branch Manager of the Glasgow office at Baird. Whether it is helping individuals prepare for retirement or navigate estate planning, Baird Financial Advisors take a holistic approach so that financial goals are reached. The Glasgow branch has dedicated financial advisors here to assist individuals, families, and business owners manage their financial needs. Please contact our office at 270-651-2663 if you want a partner who will help you achieve your financial goals.
In area funeral announcements this hour, Pamela K. Lewis Waters, 63, of Glasgow, passed away Wednesday at U of L Hospital in Louisville. She was retired from T.J. Sampson Community Hospital and a member of the Pleasant Hill Missionary Baptist Church for most of her life. She is survived by one daughter, Ashley Starr, two sisters, Barbara Matthews and Janet Sadler. The funeral service for Pamela K. Lewis Waters will be held at 1 o'clock p.m. Saturday at the Hatcher & Sadler Funeral Home, burial in the Happy Valley Memorial Gardens. Visitation 4 to 8 p.m. today and after 9 a.m. Saturday until time for the service at the funeral home. The funeral service for Dally's E. Wood 55 of Glasgow will be held at 1 p.m. Tuesday at the Hatcher & Sadler Funeral Home with cremation to follow. Visitation after 11 a.m. Tuesday at the funeral home. A graveside service for Ori Tyler Walden Jr., infant son of Ori Walden Sr., and Katrina Piper Walden will be held 2 p.m. Sunday at the Walden Family Cemetery, the Hatcher & Sadler Funeral Home in charge of those arrangements. The funeral service for Linda K. Kennard Barlow, 73, of Edmonton, will be Saturday at 1 p.m. at the Jesse Wilson Funeral Home, burial to follow in the Beech Grove Cemetery. Visitation today, 4 to 8 p.m., and will continue on Saturday after 10 a.m. Please consider small cash gifts to the Beech Grove Cemetery Fund. The funeral service for Nathaniel Dale Red Murray, 67, of Tompkinsville, will be held at 1 p.m. Saturday at the Yokely Tribal Funeral Home, with burial to follow in the Gamalia Cemetery. Visitation 4:30 to 8 today, and tomorrow Saturday, 8 a.m. until time for the service, beginning at 1 p.m. Donations in Red's memory can be made to the Gamalia Cemetery. The funeral service for Beverly Ruth Thompson, 64, of Tompkinsville, will be held at 3 p.m. tomorrow Saturday at the Bartley & Sons Funeral Home in Tompkinsville. Burial to follow in the Jane Yokely Cemetery. Visitation after 10 a.m. Saturday. Donations can be made to the Jane Yokely Cemetery or to Hospice of Barren River in memory of Beverly. The funeral service for Lillian Alice Harper, 82, of Cave City, will be held this afternoon at 1 o'clock, with burial to follow in the Cave City Cemetery. The funeral service for Robbie Lynn Deckard Dyer, 60, of Glasgow, will be held this afternoon at 1 o'clock at the Yokely Tribal Funeral Home, burial in the Gamalia Cemetery. A celebration of life service for Elizabeth Ann Wilson, 69, of Glasgow, will be held this afternoon at 2 o'clock at the Temple Baptist Church. Cremation was chosen and the Goad Funeral Home in charge. The funeral service for Joseph William Joe Hurt, 90, of Center, will be this afternoon at 1 o'clock at the McMurtry Funeral Home, with burial to follow in the G. Harvey Cemetery. Memorials are suggested to be made to the cemetery and can be left at the funeral home. The funeral service for Clyde Sally, 87, of Park City, will be this morning at 11 o'clock at the Patton Funeral Home, Park City Chapel, with burial in the Evergreen Cemetery. Full obituary information is available 24 hours a day, free online at WCLUradio.com and also on the WCLU Radio app. No login necessary.
Placed over your mantle are cherished photos of your family. In the family room, trophies of past school championships line the walls. But the one piece that truly touches your heart, that is visited regularly, that piece that takes you back in time, helps in the healing process, that is the memorial monument dedicated to your loved one.
South Central Kentucky Monuments specialize in the design and manufacturing of beautiful, lasting memorials and will help guide you through the entire process in choosing the style, size, color, and shape of your preferred monument, all the while being respectful and focused on honoring your loved one at the most affordable price. Buy direct from South Central Kentucky Monuments, open weekdays 8 to 5 at the corner of East Front Street and Columbia Avenue. They'll help you choose the most affordable monument that's as individually special and unique as the life being celebrated. The life that, no longer with us in body, remains ever so vigilant in memory. South Central Kentucky Monuments, family owned in Glasgow since 2010.
Hi, I'm Dee Dee Anderson with Elite Insurance Group. I help senior citizens with their Medicare Advantage or Medicare supplements. Our new office is at 100 Reynolds Road right here in Glasgow. We're directly behind the new car wash. You can call me at 270-404-4863 or drop on in. We look forward to helping you navigate through all of your Medicare options. Again, my name is Dee Dee Anderson with Elite Insurance Group, 100 Reynolds Road, right here in Glasgow.
Spin your way to winnings in the Big Wheel promotion at the Mint Gaming Hall Bowling Green. Earn entries daily and be chosen to play in the Friday and Saturday drawings. Three spins to win up to $1,500 cash. Great April showers gift giveaways, too. Check out themintgaming.com for details. The Mint Gaming Hall, close by near the mall. Problem gambling? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Winning just got closer.
Obituaries on WCOU, sponsored by Baird Private Wealth Management of Glasgow, South Central Kentucky Monuments, The Mint, A.F. Crow and Son Funeral Home, and D.D. Anderson, Medicare agent with Elite Insurance.
A look at weather on this Friday here on WCLU. 40% chance of rain, a breezy day, high near 60. Wind gusts today near 34 miles per hour. Tonight, a clear sky, chilly to a low down to 40. A sunny, gorgeous day tomorrow, Saturday, to kick off the weekend, high of 71. It'll be clear 56 Saturday night. Sunday will end the weekend mostly sunny and 77. And on Monday, mostly sunny, beautiful, up to 81. Again today, a few showers, breezy, high near 60, with winds reaching near 34 miles per hour.
WCLU's Good Morning Live, celebrating your birthdays and anniversaries.
Yes, sir, we are on this Friday, and I hope you're having a wonderful morning. We'd love to help you celebrate your birthday, so let's get into it today and the weekend, too. Once again, here we go, Lorraine Jones, happy birthday. Francis Lee on this 12th day of April, happy birthday. Teresa White is 52. John Michael Newberry, happy birthday. Brenda Pierce celebrates. Brenda Walker Russell is 63. Mandy Elmore, Eric Bragg is 25 today. Hope you have a wonderful day. And Loretta Davis. Two anniversaries, Steve and Nikki Garman, 21 years today. And Lillian and Evelyn Russell, 66 years today. Congratulations. Tomorrow, Saturday, the 13th, we have Ralph Riley, Glenna Gardner, Sandra Matthews, Luke Pitcock, Heather Wyatt Parsley, also Brandy Davis, Roy London, and Jack Turner all celebrate tomorrow, Saturday. And then on Sunday, we'll wrap up this weekend on the 14th with Charles Tony Hayes, Carol Flynn, Valerie Stokes, Calvin Benjamin, Martha Walden Neal, William Myatt, Wanda Scott, Betty Richardson, Jeremy Alexander, grandson, and Mary Coffey, grandmother, celebrates. Ellery Hayes and Addison Bell Allen. And let's see, we do have an anniversary for Sunday, and that's Haley and Jeremy Frazier celebrating a big wedding anniversary on Sunday the 14th. Our Good as Gold person of the day today is, Matthew and I have been debating on how to pronounce it exactly right, and I believe it's Marcia Latira. She's a volunteer at the South Central Kentucky Cultural Center. Today she's Good as Gold, and so right there on your screen, and we appreciate, I'm not sure really who nominated her, but I'm glad they did, because she's going to have a shot at winning a great meal at A Little Taste of Texas this morning, just before 8 o'clock. There will be five names in our lucky hats, so don't miss that drawing. It's a lot of fun. We do this every Friday, other than holidays, of course. So, Marcia Latera, hope you have a great day. You're Good as Gold here on WCLU Radio. Now, you can nominate someone in your life to be a Good as Gold person by visiting our website, WCLUradio.com. If you have birthdays and anniversaries, call us 651-9149, 800-956-1022. Three, get those in. All right, we're going to check your church and community calendar coming up here in just a little bit. Also, we have archives on the way with Henry Royce and Sam Terry, wrapping up another great week. A great talk this morning, looking over 100 years of history. Got a little frog in my throat this morning. So we'll look at that. That's coming up here in just a little bit. So stay with us here, 1490 AM, 103.1 FM. We're streaming online at our website, WCLUradio.com, and you can download our free app today.
Highland Pharmacy on Rogers Road in Glasgow has been a community favorite since 2012, and there's a reason for that. They consistently offer a wide range of customized services, quality care, and a commitment to you.
Highland's MedSync program aligns all your medications to be picked up at the same time each month. Free COVID tests are available through some insurance carriers, and Highland Pharmacy accepts most all insurance. Plus fast, friendly customer service and free citywide delivery.
Highland Pharmacy, a community favorite since 2012.
For over 25 years, Window World has provided quality products for homeowners around the country. Every window we sell is custom made for optimal energy efficiency and superior durability. Plus, a vinyl finish means they will never need painting. Just like our windows, entry doors from Window World are made to last, featuring a durable composite frame that will never rot. When it comes time to replace your windows or doors, trust Window World. Call 270-780-9600.
Hello, my name is Bart Warren from the South Green Street Church of Christ. This is today's word of encouragement. Please listen to the word of God, John chapter 1, verses 14 through 16. And the word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we've seen his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth. John bore witness about him and cried out, "This was he of whom I said, he who comes after me ranks before me, because he was before me. For from his fullness we have all received grace upon grace." The application. We've all sinned, every single one of us. We all continue to sin, every single one of us. Thankfully, Jesus came to this earth to offer us grace. What a blessing to know and follow Jesus. Encourage each other with these words. May the grace of our Lord Jesus be with you.
Been longing to spruce up your home with a fresh coat of paint? Get it done and save on Valspar paint at Glasgow Building Supply. You'll get up to $75 back on your favorite Valspar paints during our spring rebate event. Now through April 21st, choose Valspar Accolade Interior Paint and save $15 per gallon. Find colorful savings on other great Valspar paints too. Now through April 21st at Glasgow Building Supply on the bypass. See the rebate URL in store for more details.
We're going abroad for the first time in years, to Spain. So we started using Babbel.
And started learning Spanish fast.
With Babbel, you can start having conversations in another language in just 3 weeks.
¿Cómo te llamas?
¿Cómo te llamas?
When you learn a language, you want to actually use it. Babbel is designed with that goal in mind.
In just 3 weeks, we're starting to have conversations in Spanish. Gracias, Babbel.
Babbel, language for life. Now try Babbel for free at Babbel.com. That's Babbel.com.
Good morning, live on this fun Friday's edition. Hope you're doing well today. And let's check your church and community calendar. Lots going on. Now, if you like Southern gospel music, High Road is coming to Glasgow, a very popular group in the Southern gospel world. They're going to be in concert this Sunday, the 14th, at 6 o'clock p.m. at Southside Baptist Church at 2727 Sconceville Road here in Glasgow. Enjoy a wide array of musical styles from country to bluegrass, Southern gospel, contemporary Christian music. And let's tell you, they're some of the best, too. It's High Road coming to Glasgow the 14th, 6 p.m. No admission, of course. A love offering will be accepted. Everyone welcome to attend that. Metcalf County Farmers Market will be open today, 8 a.m. to 1 p.m., 422 East Street. And this is a Kentucky Proud Market. Wisdom Faith Christian Academy spring fundraiser will be held today at the Academy Gym. Dinner at 5 o'clock, silent auction 5 to 6, and a regular auction at 6 o'clock. The Boys and Girls Club of Glasgow Barron County is having Parents Night Out. This is where the youth are trained in background checks. And their backgrounds have been checked, of course, to take care of your child for ages 5 to 12 and from 6:30 to 10 p.m. That's tonight. Activities include snack time, dance, music, movies, games, playtime. For information, call 629-3871 to sign up your child, 270-629-3871. And also in conjunction with the National Library Week, the Metcalf County Library is having a Customer Appreciation Day today, starting at 10:30 this morning. Stop by the library for giveaways, fun, food, and music. A lot of fun there. Also, the Barron County Conservation District will have a tree giveaway today from 8 a.m. to noon at the Soil Conservation Office parking lot on the YMCA Way to celebrate Earth Day and Arbor Day. So, a free tree. What about that? Fountain Run Barbecue Festival will have their first annual beauty pageant this Saturday the 13th at the Fountain Run First Baptist Christian Life Center. with the pageant beginning at 9:15. The entry fee is $15. Admission is $5 with 5 and under free, of course. For more information, fountainrunbbq@gmail.com. Just email them today. We'll have more local announcements next hour. We are a little pressed for time this morning. We have some fellas in here wanting to talk a little bit, so... And those fellas, Henry Royce and Sam Terry, with our morning archives, you don't want to miss this conversation. They're going to look over 100 years of history, talk about some things, some people, and some things that happened in the area. So don't miss that. It's headed your way in 30 seconds. Stay with us.
Hi, Ann and Gina,
a.k.a. Thelma and Louise here, and we're up for a challenge.
If you want a fun shopping experience where you can find ladies and girls trendy new styles arriving weekly, then get over to All About Me Boutique.
Thelma and Louise's superpower is our quick design sense to help you put together an amazing outfit for any event.
We will make you feel special.
You may even get to be a model for a day.
Let us take the stress out of your shopping and make it a fun adventure.
Get over to All About Me, where it's really all about you.
804 West Main Street here in Glasgow.
Happy Friday morning, everybody. You're on WCLU, and we're glad you are, because it's time for us to talk about the archives. We've had a busy, busy, busy week right here. If you love history, this is the place to be. If you love history, the place to be either today or tomorrow is to come to the Cultural Center and see the last two possible days to visit the Kentucky Heritage Quilt Society's President's Challenge. All those quilts on display, they're going away after tomorrow. You will have missed it. Also, if you love history, you don't want to miss tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock over at the Glasgow Cemetery, where the Sam Terry is going to be conducting a most fabulous cemetery tour. So much color commentary. I bet Sam is here. You don't even know everything you're going to talk about yet, do you?
Probably not.
But it's always, it's a very pleasant undertaking. But these are two things that are coming up that you don't want to mess up. Shall we go down and do our last archive for the week?
I think so.
All right. We've got a story in the Glasgow Times, some Cave City news here. I wish there were some pictures of this. The Cave City News story says that next Thursday evening in the Cave City School Building is going to be given the Old Maids Convention by the ladies of the Eastern Star Chapter. This will be one of the funniest and best amateur plays given at Cave City for quite a while, and the public is urged to come. The funds derived from this go to the building fund of the Eastern Star Old Ladies Home. Therefore, it's a worthy cause and good entertainment. The price is 35 cents for adults. My goodness. I'd pay a lot more than that.
Yes.
What I can envision how funny that would have been, Sam, in 1924. The Eastern Star Chapter. How about 1934? Let's see. It's kind of a neat headline here in the Glasgow Times from 1934. You pick it up, and the headline reads, "Best be careful!" Exclamation point. What's the rest of the story, you say? Spring may be on its way, but the old season barometer, the tree in the southeast corner of the courthouse yard, has not yet put out a single leaf. When it does, spring is here. All right. The southwest corner of the courthouse, that would be, let's see, over there, right, or kind of across from George J's, would it be?
No, it would be across from the Veterans Memorial.
Okay. All right, okay.
The old post office, old school Board of Education offices, and the old uptowner.
Okay, so there was a tree up there that's the barometer they were watching for the first leaf. In 1934.
Well, people who watch such things do pay attention to the occurrence of such.
And probably have a lot of documentation to back up the accuracy of it.
It would be interesting to know what kind of tree it was.
1944, the headline just tells the truth. There's a great war picture at the plaza. A film which tells more about the bombing of Germany than 1,000 headlines tells the story of the 8th Air Force with a vividness which makes it an outstanding documentary and cinematic drama surpassing all fictional aviation films. Heroes at the center of the story are the Flying Fortress Memphis Belle and her crew, who battled through 25 missions over Germany. The War Activities Committee requested every theater show the Memphis Belle so that every American may see it. The film will be playing as an added attraction at the Plaza for 2 days only, April the 21st and the 22nd.
My goodness.
And as we were as patriotic as this community was and continues to be, but was back then, you know that a lot of folks went there and saw that two-day showing of the great war picture at the Plaza. 1954. Glasgow Times reports the community Easter service will be held at the Star Drive-In Theater Sunday, with the Reverend Mr. Whitmer officiating. The services will be starting at 6 a.m. and include a choir selection by groups from Glasgow churches. How about that? A nice location, kind of a drive-in Easter morning
service. It was, and the Ashleys were wonderful to host that for many, many years.
Yes, indeed. It's a wonderful location. This was the day in 1964 that we learned that several hundred dollars in money and merchandise were missing this morning from Richardson's Grocery out at 88 Kentucky. Missing were $116 in quarters, $22 in bills, 85 to 90 cartons of mixed cigarettes, a 17-inch portable TV, a 20-gauge Winchester shotgun, about $400 worth of knives, and there's been a $200 reward that's been offered. My goodness, these thieves were very specific on what they took out of there.
It sounds like it.
At 88, and it sounded like they took their time and got a bunch of stuff. Let's talk some more about some Easter services here in 1974. Sam, this is in the Glasgow Times. The area churches are planning Easter services. Sunrise service will be held at 6:30 a.m. on the lawn of the District No. 6 TB Hospital, with the Reverend Billy Compton of the Calvary Baptist Church delivering the message. Another wonderful outdoor venue to have a community-wide Easter service there out at the District 6 TB Hospital lawn. This was a big day in 1984 when the UK Wildcats actually came to Barron County High School for an exhibition game between this year's seniors and the UK alumni team. You know, everybody loved that one.
Absolutely. I bet it was a packed house.
No question about it. 1984. 1994, we learned that the recent heavy rains have swelled Barron River Reservoir to new record high levels. At 10 o'clock Wednesday morning, the level stood at 578.87, which is actually 26 feet above the summer pool of 552 feet. You know, there were several years there in a row in back in the late 90s and the early 2000s where they never even got the beach open. The rain,
I recall
it was
that.
So far over the height of the pool at the lake. But you had to play the cards that Mother Nature deals, and they worked with that. And it's a wonderful place when it's open, for sure. 2004, we have some news. This is actually in the Barron County Progress, a big advertisement that's now showing at the Marquee Cinema. The Girl Next Door, The Alamo, Home on the Range, Hellboy, Walking Tall, Scooby-Doo, Monsters Unleashed, The Prince and Me, Jersey Girls, and The Passion of Christ. What a variety.
It certainly is.
At the Marquee Cinema. You can go out there and see them all as a part of this particular weekend in 2004's showing. As reported in there in the Barron County Progress. And let's see, 2014, 10 years ago today, the folks with the Memorial Day Committee, the Patriot Award nominations are being sought for Memorial Day ceremony coming up on May the 26th. And I think that's one of the most thoughtful and prestigious undertakings that happens with regard to our veterans here. The Patriot Award.
It certainly is. And a good reminder, I think it's safe to say that that'll be coming up again. So do your part.
That's right.
And suggest people, nominate people to the Barron County Veterans Association to receive that award.
Indeed. Sam, thank you for another great week, and I hope you have a great turnout tomorrow at the cemetery for the big walking tour, okay?
We'll look forward to it.
And we'll reconvene next week and start it all over again, okay? Thanks to everybody for listening to the archives here on WCLU.
Weather from the WCLU Weather Center, brought to you by South Central Bank.
Attention home buyers and homeowners. If you're shopping for a mortgage or considering home financing, call one of Kentucky's top mortgage lenders, South Central Bank. Recognized as the area's best mortgage company, we are ready to help you walk through every step of the borrowing process. With experienced lenders and a full range of loan solutions that suit your budget, South Central Bank can make your dreams become reality. Contact us today. You can even apply online at southcentralbank.com. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
A few showers possible today at 40%, a breezy day with a high near 60, west winds 11 to 16. They could kick up as high today as 34 miles per hour. Tonight, clear and quite chilly as we dip down to 40, with winds reaching near 22. Sunshine, beautiful on Saturday to kick off the weekend, high of 71, with a west wind at 10. Saturday night, clear, 56. Mostly sunny Sunday to wrap up the weekend, high of 77. With those winds continuing, southwest 13 to 18, gusting near 26 miles per hour on Sunday. Sunday night, clear and 60. Monday, mostly sunny, high of 81. Monday night, mostly cloudy, 62. And partly sunny, breezy again on Tuesday with a high of 79. Looking ahead to next Wednesday, 40% chance of rain and maybe a thunder shower back in the area. Partly sunny, breezy, high near 80. Again today, 40% chance that you'll see a shower, maybe an isolated thunderstorm. Today's high near 60 with wind gusts today near 34 miles per hour. 73% humidity right now. Our pressure, 29.87. Winds are at 12. Visibility about 15 miles, but please be careful out there as you commute this morning. Sunrise was this hour at 6:12. Sunset tonight, 7:16. 48 degrees this morning here at WCLU. Hope you're up and at it on this fun Friday. Weather brought to you by our good friends at South Central Bank. Morning trivia straight ahead. You stay with us.
WCLU, celebrating all the businesses, organizations, and the people that make Barron County a wonderful place to be. It's WCLU's The Best of Barron. Log on to WCLUradio.com and make your nominations in over 100 categories anytime from now until the end of April. Nominees will go into the Best of Barron ballot for your votes in the month of May. Make sure your favorites are represented. The Best of Barron 2024. From your home for local, WCLU.
Hey, this is Carly, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A Chicken Minis is the combination of flavors. The first thing I always taste is the honey butter. It gets me going in the morning. The Chicken Minis are phenomenal. The roll is soft, and the chicken is crispy. I never had chicken for breakfast before, but they were so good. I told my mom and sister about them, and now they're a family thing. It's the perfect breakfast bite.
Breakfast starts with Chicken Minis and Simply Orange Juice on the Chick-fil-A app. Real customer paid for their testimonial.
Is reviewing life insurance on your to-do list? Now's the perfect time to add it. A friend recently told me that securing life insurance sooner rather than later can help you lock in lower rates for years to come. So I bumped this up on my list and got it done. I called SelectQuote and couldn't believe how easy and affordable life insurance is. I'm 40 and got a $500,000 policy for $16 a month. My husband's also 40 and his $500,000 policy was only $18 a month. Plus, with SelectQuote same-day coverage, there was no medical exam required, and we were covered by the time we hung up. Knowing I have this checked off my list feels amazing, but the peace of mind knowing my family is protected feels even better.
Call SelectQuote at 1-800-280-8787. That's 1-800-280-8787. Or go to SelectQuote.com to get your free quote today. That's 1-800-280-8787. Details on example rate at SelectQuote.com.
Hurry up and try new Little Caesars Crazy Puffs. They're four fun-sized Crazy Puffs packed with layers of pepperoni, cheese, and sauce, and perfect on the go. Enjoy Crazy Puffs on a unicycle. Whoa! In a hot air balloon! Or riding piggyback on your friend Keith. Faster, Keith, faster!
Can I have a delicious Crazy Puff?
Sorry, Keith, they're too tasty. Whee! Try new Little Caesars Crazy Puffs on the go for only $3.99.
Pizza, pizza.
Available at participating locations. Prices may vary. Prices higher in Alaska, Hawaii, and third-party online sites, plus tax.
WCLU Good Morning Live Trivia Time.
Pizza, pizza.
Your chance to win our final trivia question of the week, 651-9149, 800-956-1023. One winner per household per 30 days, okay? Keep that in mind today, and again, 651-9149. This morning, we're going to talk about a famous person. You've got to reveal who it is, okay? Who am I? Here's your clues. Okay, I'm going to give you a few clues, see if you can solve it. I am from Cordell, Kentucky. I was playing music at the age of 5. I was performing on TV at age 7. And finally, I've had 12 number one songs. In particular, country songs. Who am I? 651-9149. Good morning, trivia.
Ricky Skaggs.
You got it, buddy. Ricky Skaggs, fast on the draw today. Who is this?
It's Terry Jackson.
How you doing, Terry?
Doing good.
Hadn't talked to you in about a month or so.
Well, it's been about a month.
Right there on your screen, if you folks are watching this morning, Ricky Skaggs, who his appearance has sure changed over the years. He used to be this little clean-cut fellow. Now he's got kind of a long gray hair. Kind of looks like George Washington a little bit. Terry, are you a fan of Ricky Skaggs?
Oh, I like to hear him, yeah.
Boy, he's good.
I don't think Bill Monroe thought too much of him on the first.
Yeah.
Come around.
And, you know, they became great friends, and Ricky actually had Bill Monroe in one of his 1980 hits, Country Boy. I don't know if you've ever seen that video, but Bill Monroe is actually in that video dancing.
I don't think so.
Well, Ricky Skaggs, that's our answer this week from Cordell, Kentucky. I think he was actually raised in a little town called Martha. Started playing at the age of 7. He was on TV with Flat and Scruggs. You know, that's quite an accomplishment for a 7-year-old kid.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I saw
a
video of that.
Yeah, boy. Oh, Terry, you just want a free pizza again. Hope you enjoy that. And I need your address, so I'll put you on hold, okay?
Okay, appreciate it.
Yes, sir. Stand by. Terry Jackson, our big winner. The answer, of course, Ricky Skaggs. That's our final trivia of the week. We'll play again Monday. Stay with us. News straight ahead.
Welcome to hour number 2 of Good Morning Live on WCLU Glasgow. W2760 Glasgow. Local news, sports, information, and fun.
CBS News on the Hour, sponsored by O'Reilly Auto Parts.
I'm Stacey Lynn. Iran is looking to punish Israel for a strike on its consulate in Syria that killed several of its top generals. A retaliatory attack could be imminent. How's the White House responding? Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre.
Obviously, we've seen the threats coming from Iran, and so we have made ourselves very clear where we stand in supporting Israel's security. That is ironclad. That does not change. I'm just not going to get into details about our operational procedures from here.
Another round of student loan forgiveness is coming. CBS's Bo Erickson says more than $7 billion more will be canceled.
In total, the Biden administration has canceled $153 billion of student loan debt for more than 4 million Americans. And senior administration officials defended the legal basis of these programs as a lawsuit was recently filed by several Republican attorneys general throughout the country.
House Speaker Johnson's heading to Florida today to meet with former President Trump. The two will make remarks on election security. CBS's Robert Costa.
By standing with Trump, Johnson's allies tell me behind the scenes they believe he will solidify his own political standing.
So much rain in such a short time caused a whole lot of problems.
Widespread flooding caused by torrential rain led to high water rescues in the hills of eastern Kentucky and western Pennsylvania, as well as the mountains of West Virginia. Craig Deesher lives in drenched Oakdale, Pennsylvania, outside Pittsburgh.
There was a family, an older lady that was in there, and it was about to reach into her first floor, but she was afraid to even come out. So it was flooding so bad and the water was moving so fast.
There was also extensive flooding in and around Tallahassee, Florida. Jim Crisula, CBS News.
The former interpreter for Shohei Ohtani is expected in court today, charged with allegedly stealing millions of dollars of the baseball star's money to pay off gambling debts. CBS's Adam Yamaguchi is following the story in Los Angeles.
Ipe Mizuhara, according to the U.S. attorney, found himself in very, very deep. And so at some point, he began to funnel money from Shohei Ohtani's account to pay off the bookie.
He faces years in prison. Lots of reaction pouring into the death of O.J. Simpson. Cato Kaelin, his famed house guest, spoke out in a video he posted to social media.
I wish to express my love and compassion to the Goldmans, to Fred and to Kim, to the family of the beautiful Nicole Brown Simpson. May we always cherish her memories.
Cato was one of the witnesses in what's been called the trial of the century. Ahead of the open on Wall Street, Dow futures rise, S&P has slipped. This is CBS News.
Think O'Reilly Auto Parts for all your car care needs. Get the parts and service you need fast from the professional parts people at O'Reilly Auto Parts.
eBay Motors is here for the ride. Go ahead, feel your engine. Admire that perfectly installed exhaust. Your vehicle's moving along this freeway like it was made from fresh installs and a whole lot of love. With eBay Motors, you get over 122 million parts to keep it running. And with eBay Guaranteed Fit, they'll be the perfect fit every time. Plus at these prices, well, we're burning rubber, not cash. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only. Exclusions apply.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential, but finding those people can be a major hassle. Unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze. ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies candidates with the right skills, sends you great matches, then you can easily invite them to apply. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. See for yourself. Go to ZipRecruiter.com/free to try ZipRecruiter for free. That's ZipRecruiter.com.
Are you one of thousands of men suffering from BPH, also known as enlarged prostate? This common condition often makes it difficult to urinate and can cause the bladder to weaken over time. Sleep and even sexual health may also be impacted. TJ Regional Health is now offering the most advanced, minimally invasive surgical treatment for BPH called Aquablation. Aquablation provides long-lasting relief without unwanted side effects. For more information, please visit tjregionalhealth.org/aquablation.
Your source for local for more than 30 years. This is WCLU Local News.
For WCLU Local News, I'm Wes Royce reporting. In a poignant tribute to the legacy of the late Judge Tom Emberton, the Metcalf County Judicial Center is set to undergo a significant transformation. Not only will the center be renamed to the Tom Emberton Judicial Center, but a statue in the late judge's likeness will be constructed in front of the center to greet guests and residents of the small town. Judge Emberton, a revered figure in Metcalf County's legal landscape, left an indelible mark on the community through his unwavering commitment to justice and tireless advocacy for the rights of its citizens. Tommy Garrett, Metcalf County Clerk, knew the judge personally, as he explains.
Of course, Judge Emberton was a personal friend of mine all my life. His wife was my sixth grade teacher. Judge was just a good man, and nobody in Metcalf County ever said a bad word about him. He used to live by my great-grandfather. And my great-grandfather would be milking, and Judge Emberton would come down there, and he would tell him stories. And so when Judge Emberton went to the military, he corresponded with my grandfather, my great-grandfather. And so anyway, then Judge and I became really, really close friends.
The decision to rename the center comes as a fitting tribute to Judge Emberton's enduring legacy. Garrett, a retired Kentucky State Police trooper, had a first-hand experience with the judge professionally. This, combined with their personal attachments, led to Garrett making the call to State Representative Jason Nemus to begin the process of immortalizing the judge.
Well, I contacted Jason Nemus and I, Representative Nemus and I, and Amy Neighbors, a representative, were just discussing it. And Jason really wanted to name this the Judge Emberton Courthouse. And so Representative Neighbors' husband, Jason, and I have started a project that we're going to build a they're going to put a statue of Judge Emberton out in front of the courthouse.
Construction of the statue is slated to begin in October, with local artist Russell Faxon heading the project. As preparations for the statue's construction get underway, residents of Metcalf County eagerly anticipate the opportunity to honor Judge Tom Emberton and celebrate his enduring legacy of service and dedication. Garrett, as a final thought to his late friend and pillar of the community, said,
"There's never been a more distinguished person for Metcalf County than Tom Emberton, in my opinion."
Metcalf Fiscal Court met yesterday morning. Gage Wilson has the details.
Metcalf Fiscal Court convened yesterday for a heated discussion surrounding the renewal of the city's CAECO insurance policy, sparking discontent among many county employees. The deliberations, which highlighted diverging opinions among court members, underscored the challenges of balancing fiscal responsibility with the welfare of county workers. The CAECO insurance policy, a staple benefit for county employees, has come under scrutiny among the county employees with concerns over coverage adequacy. As the court weighed the pros and cons of renewing the policy, tensions ran high among county workers who voiced their dissatisfaction with the current insurance arrangement. The discourse between County Treasurer Paige Edwards and a dissatisfied county employee summed up the state of the discussion.
I'd like to see you check into some more companies or something, because what I've got is not worth 15 cents. Health insurance.
Well, we go to CAECO, and Humana's getting out of the health insurance business.
There's a lot more companies out there than CAECO, and I believe we could get a whole lot better insurance for less money. Now, there's a lot more employees that's not happy with it either, but maybe it's not here.
Judge Executive Larry Wilson proposed that a special called meeting inviting local insurance groups to speak to the county and public directly would be the best course of action to the agreement of the magistrates. The meeting date has not been set as of now, but court members will have to decide to stay with CAECO or swap to a different company before the budget approval in June. With WCLU Radio, I'm Gage Wilson.
Metcalf County Middle School is proud to announce 7 students have been selected for the 2024 Rogers Explorers program. The Rogers Explorers program is an intensive 3-day, 2-night program focused on cultivating skills in leadership, technology, math, science, and community service. The following 8th grade students received invitations, 5 as explorers and 2 as alternates: Morgan Avery, Lydia Bennett, Haley Gilliam, Cade Huffman, Leah Kerr, Mackenzie Grissom, and Haley Neal. Metcalf County Middle School Principal Jenny Stotts Lundy said, "I am thrilled to congratulate these exceptional students on their selection for the Rogers Explorers program. This achievement is a testament to their dedication, talent, and potential to make a positive impact in our community." Rogers Explorers is developed, coordinated, and supervised by the Center for Rural Development in partnership with the University of the Cumberlands, Lindsey Wilson College, Eastern Kentucky University, Morehead State University, University of Pikeville, and Union College. Activities are both educational and fun. Students participate in practical college courses, fine-tune leadership skills, and develop a network of friends and resources throughout Southern and Eastern Kentucky regions. In his final segment from the recent Barren River Area Development District Summit, Gage Wilson covers what was discussed about housing issues in the region.
Amidst the picturesque backdrop of the Cave Area Convention Center, the Regional Barren River Area Development District, or BRAD, summit delved into critical discussions surrounding housing issues plaguing the region. A breakout session dedicated to exploring the challenges and opportunities in the realm of housing garnered significant attention from attendees eager to address pressing concerns affecting communities across the district. Led by Patrick Bowen, president of Bowen National Research, the group was educated on affordable housing shortages to infrastructure deficiencies and zoning regulations. Kevin Maya, director of the Joint City-County Planning Commission, had a keen interest in this session and explained to WCLU what steps the Planning Commission is researching to help combat prohibitive housing costs.
The Planning Commission for our community has taken some initiative steps. We're obviously bound by what the community, the legislative bodies want, and we've looked at alternative measures for development, whether it being the manufactured modular homes like they spoke about, but also those non-traditional structures that you might not think about, such as tiny homes, what is an actual tiny home, and those that are non-traditional structures, shipping containers, things of that nature. So we've started taking a look at some of that stuff.
While the idea of tiny homes or modular homes may sound like a hodgepodge solution to a dire need, Myatt spoke on the regulations and planning that would go into the commission's role in the construction of such structures.
You know, the building code still comes into play for those things that still have to happen, but it's our responsibility to try to see if we can get close to meeting that housing need.
Communities in the area are not powerless, though. By becoming more involved in local government and planning endeavors, residents can pressure local governmental bodies to make the necessary steps to bring in more housing options by supporting infrastructure development, as Maya explains.
Some of the things that our local legislative bodies can do is, you know, get involved with infrastructure, provide the necessary water, sewer lines, electric lines, have those things pre-built so that your developers are reducing their costs, and hopefully we'll pass that on to whoever you're selling it to or renting to in that kind of situation. Okay.
This is the final part in a series where WCLU went into a deep dive on all of the activities and educational materials that the Brad Summit had gone through. With WCLU Radio, I'm Gage Wilson.
Most people will hesitate before planning a funeral in advance.
The funeral? We'll arrange that when the time comes.
But there's a lot to be said for advance planning. For one thing, you have the peace of mind of knowing that your arrangements have all been made. You can consider the options when your mind is clear, and you'll have the relief of knowing that your loved one will be well cared for. A.F. Crow & Son Funeral Home, a celebration of love.
In more local news at this hour, once seen only as a game for playtime, video games are now considered esports. Gage Wilson met with a Caverna Middle School student who is already seeing success as an esports athlete.
In a groundbreaking achievement, a senior from Caverna High School has soared to the top. Diego Ochoa quenched first in the KHSAA Esports Madden NFL 24 Solos. For Ochoa, this victory is a culmination of dedication, perseverance, and skill. Competing against peers across the state, he demonstrated exceptional prowess, navigating complex strategies and executing precise maneuvers with finesse, as was made evident as he explains the final moments of one of his matches.
Well, it was a tough game. It came out to the last second. I got a last second field goal.
Ochoa was joined by his teammate, Caverna Jr. Ladarius Wagner, who explained to WCLU why esports was different from more traditional athletics.
You don't have to be super athletic to play. You don't have to be, I don't know, like a super gamer. I mean, if you just want to try something out and get a new hobby, this is the perfect place to do it.
Beyond the thrill of victory, this achievement underscores the value of esports as a legitimate and respected extracurricular activity. Far from simply being a pastime, esports offers students a platform to hone valuable skills such as critical thinking, problem solving, communication, and teamwork. Skills that are essential not only in gaming, but also in academics and future careers. Ochoa was unsure what his future with esports may look like, as he and Wagner both were involved with the school's football team. Time was a major concern of theirs. Both young men, however, would like to see esports as a part of their academic career, as Wagner spoke on.
I would like to continue playing esports going into college if I had the extra time, but me also being an athlete, I don't know if I have extra time as I go to college.
The student's coach on the physical and virtual field, Tim Gower, elaborated on why esports at the school is not only beneficial to the social well-being of the team, but also the level playing field students can take advantage of.
That's one good thing about esports. It doesn't matter how big a school you are, if you're on the same, use the same equipment, same level. I mean, there's no extra stuff you can buy. You don't have to be the richest kid in the world. Everything's equal. And that's what's good about it, just the best player wins.
The recognition of esports by KHSAA also signifies a broader shift in the perception of gaming. No longer confined to the realm of entertainment, esports is increasingly being embraced as a legitimate form of competition, deserving of the same recognition and support as traditional sports. With WCLU Radio, I'm Gage Wilson.
Barron County government will have two committee meetings this morning. The jail committee will meet at 8:45 a.m. at the Government Center third floor conference room to discuss renewal of a contract for comprehensible correctional care. The transportation committee will meet in the same location just after at 9:30 a.m. Items on the agenda include open materials and supplies bids, open truck bids, open wind school LWF replacement bids, private roads and name signs, fuel tanks, truck repair bill, road department renovations bid, and other business. For more local news and information, remember to turn to your home for local on the web, WCLUradio.com. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and X. And remember to hit the subscribe button on YouTube for our latest live streams of local sports and videos. For WCLU Local News, I'm Wes Royce reporting.
Attention homebuyers and homeowners. If you're shopping for a mortgage or considering home financing, call one of Kentucky's top mortgage lenders, South Central Bank. Recognized as the area's best mortgage company, we are ready to help you walk through every step of the borrowing process. With experienced lenders and a full range of loan solutions that suit your budget, South Central Bank can make your dreams become reality. Contact us today. You can even apply online at southcentralbank.com. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
This is the Kentucky News Network.
Lexington is moving closer to passing an ordinance which would ban the sale of puppies and kittens in pet stores unless partnered with a shelter. The Public Safety and Social Services Committee voted this week to approve the legislation, which will head for a full council vote in May. The ordinance would ban puppy and kitten mail sales and is already in place in Louisville, Elizabethtown, and Radcliffe. Shelters remain at capacity, and the ordinance would help support efforts to find homes for those animals. A person is dead after a head-on crash Thursday morning in Foster. Police report a car on AA Highway veered left and struck a transit van waiting to turn at New Hope Road in Pendleton County. The driver of the car died on the scene. The two people in the van were taken to the hospital with non-critical injuries. The accident is under investigation. Senator David Yates is trying to push through a bill for debate that would add exemptions to Kentucky's abortion ban. Hatley's law would add exemptions for cases of rape and incest. The senator is trying to get the bill on the Senate floor for a full vote. The bill has been held up in legislation and has not been brought up for debate. Yates has today and Monday left in the session to get a vote on the bill. A woman is hospitalized in serious condition after being struck by a truck on Wednesday night. Fonda Crow was walking along Highway 1016 when she was struck by a truck driven by Martin Laws. It's unclear if Laws will face any charges. Police are investigating. It appears the search for a new head coach is over in Lexington. The UK Wildcats are preparing to offer Mark Pope of Brigham Young a five-year contract. The two sides quickly engaged Thursday afternoon after Baylor Scott Drew and UConn's Dan Hurley turned down offers. This contract is for 5 years, an average of $5.5 million per season. Pope is in line to replace John Calipari after 15 seasons. I'm Lee Mowen.
This is the Kentucky News Network.
Life insurance is one of those things that just about everybody needs, but few people actually have. Hey, if you die unexpectedly without life insurance, guess what? You'll leave your family with even a bigger mess. Life insurance will help replace your family's income. It'll help cover burial expenses. Life insurance can even help pay off debt like credit cards and medical bills. Life insurance can even pay for college. And if you own a business and you die, life insurance can help your business from collapsing. It can even help cover estate taxes. Life insurance has never been more affordable and needed. Plus, you can always shop around even if you have a plan and save some money. So call the Life Insurance Quote Line right now for free pricing information.
800-917-8730. 800-917-8730. 800-917-8730. That's 800-917-8730.
A look at weather on this Friday here on WCLU. 40% chance of rain, a breezy day, high near 60. Wind gusts today near 34 miles per hour. Tonight, a clear sky, chilly to a low down to 40. A sunny, gorgeous day tomorrow, Saturday, to kick off the weekend, high of 71. It'll be clear 56 Saturday night. Sunday will end the weekend mostly sunny and 77. And on Monday, mostly sunny, beautiful, up to 81. Again today, a few showers, breezy, high near 60. With winds reaching near 34 miles per hour.
Here's a look at your local sports on WCLU. In baseball action yesterday, it was Bowling Green that picked up a big win over Glasgow 14-4. In upcoming baseball action tonight, Marion County travels to Taylor County. Barron County plays host to Monroe County. Allen County Scottsville is on the road against Butler County. Franklin Simpson is at home against Westmoreland, Tennessee. Metcalf County is on the road against John Hardin. It'll be Edmondson County taking on Meade County. Caverna travels to Warren Central, and Warren East will play host to Logan County. And in upcoming softball action, Russell County travels to LaRue County. Barron County plays host to Cumberland County. Franklin Simpson is on the road against Christian County. Glasgow is at home against Clinton County. Adair County is on the road at Hart County. Edmondson County will go up against Whitesville Trinity, and it'll be Warren East playing host to Greenwood. To stay up up to date with all the latest high school sports scores and schedules. All you have to do is head to our website at WCLUradio.com and click the sports tab.
Happy Friday. I'm Scott Fitzgerald. We got a busy weekend of sports ahead. Let's get you caught up on an active day here on the Kentucky News Network. University of Kentucky men's basketball is finalizing a five-year deal with BYU head coach Mark Pope to become the Wildcats' next head coach. Pope follows John Calipari, who left for Arkansas after 15 seasons. In five seasons at BYU, Pope went 110-52, leading the Cougars to two NCAA tournament berths. He played for Kentucky and was a member of the Wildcats' 1996 national team. Over to college baseball. Speaking of the Cats, how about that 8th-ranked Kentucky Wildcat baseball team? They're calling Plainsman Park on the campus of Auburn University home this weekend. Last night, former St. Xavier Tiger Ryan Nicholson made full use of its outer dimensions.
Here's a swing and a drive to deep right. Kentucky reclaims the lead on a towering home run by Nicholson to right.
Yeah, the former Cincinnati Bearcat went 444 yards to give Kentucky a 6-4 win in their series opener. And for just the second time in school history, the Cats have won 8 straight SEC games. And staying on the college diamond, after the annual battle for the Bluegrass and college softball was canceled between Louisville and Kentucky, both teams are back at it today. Kentucky is home taking on Georgia, while the Cardinals are off to Atlanta to take on Georgia Tech. The Reds series finale against the Brewers was postponed along the banks of the Ohio yesterday due to rain. The Natty is on the south side of Chicago tonight to take on the White Sox. Andrew Abbott will get the nod. Meanwhile, the St. Louis Cardinals are out west in the desert. They're going to take on the Arizona Diamondbacks. They'll send Steven Matz to the hill. And play at the Masters was suspended yesterday due to darkness after a late start due to rain. When it was all said and done, Bryson DeChambeau was atop the leaderboard after shooting a 65. Meanwhile, Kentucky's own Justin Thomas shot an even 72. That puts him tied for 32nd. And finally, in horse racing tomorrow, Stone Street Lexington marks the last hope for Hades, who is looking to make it into the starting gate on the first Saturday of May at the Kentucky Derby, this after winning the Grade 3 Holy Bowl earlier. I'm Scott Fitzgerald.
This is the Kentucky News Network.
Do you know what red flags to look for when considering an investment opportunity? Fraudulent sellers might make unsolicited contact, tell you everyone is buying it, and pressure you to invest right now. They make hefty promises over the phone, but never put them in writing. At the Department of Financial Institutions, we have a saying: if it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. We're on a mission to educate Team Kentucky and protect your hard-earned dollars. Visit us online at kfi.ky.gov for more information.
Be safe, Kentucky. Buckle up and put the phone down. Put your
phone down. Paid with funds through the Kentucky Office of Highway Safety.
All of us love sports, but not all sports are created equal. College sports have big budgets, dedicated alumni networks, and corporate sponsorships. Professional sports have even deeper pockets. Millionaire owners, lucrative TV and radio deals, and merchandise sales. High school sports have you. Everyone agrees high school sports give us plenty of reasons to cheer. And now's a great time for us to give back. Supporting your hometown high school won't cost you much, but it will go a long way to ensuring the games we love the most are here to stay. Kentucky High School Sports. They're good for our kids, good for our community, and best of all, they're good for you.
This message presented by the Kentucky High School Athletic Association and the Kentucky High School Athletic Directors Association.
Hello, I'm Gary Fogle. Welcome to Kentucky Sports Memories. And today, a comparison, 50 years difference in salaries in Major League Baseball.
At Watson's, we've been delivering all the family fun and relaxation to our local community for over 50 years. Our mission is to provide high-quality home recreational products and home furnishings to our customers that bring families and friends together for a break from the daily stresses of life. Shop the largest local selection of in-stock products for your home, inside and out, and get the guaranteed lowest price in the USA. Only at Watson's. We have all the fun.
This week I've been talking to Leo Foster, a native of Covington, Kentucky, northern part of the state, because he's the Kentucky connection to Hank Aaron when he hit his 715th career home run back in 1974, 50 years ago, April of 74, when he hit that home run to break Babe Ruth's all-time home run record. So we've been talking about that with Leo, but also talked to him about his career a little bit, and also about the differences in salaries, because when Leo came up to the big leagues in 1971, there was no such thing as free agency. A player was locked into the team he played for unless that team decided to cut him, not renew his contract, or trade him. But there was no such thing as free agency. And free agency changed everything when it came to salaries. And I talked to him about the money in baseball from when he played to today.
Obviously, you're in your 70s now. You've been away from the game for a long time. What do you think about the salaries that guys are making today compared to what you made and guys like you made back when you played?
When I got called up in 71, I was making $12,500.
Really?
Yeah, that was in 71. What, 70, yeah, 71. Utility player today in the big leagues, he's making $700,000 a year.
Well, that's the minimum.
That's the minimum, yeah.
And some are making more than that if they're a veteran.
He's a veteran utility player, hell, he's making millions of dollars, maybe $2 or $3 million or more.
Yeah. Right.
I can sit here and say we didn't make any money, but in those days, the money we made was a lot of money.
But still, most players had to get a job in the off season, which he did every off season, to help pay the bills. Leo Foster, he played parts of 5 seasons in the major leagues as a utility infielder, played back in the 1970s. So it was on the field when Hank Aaron hit that memorable home run in April 50 years ago. That's it for the show this week. Thanks for listening. Gary Fogle, Kentucky Sports Memories.
Thank you, Gary. Kentucky Sports Memories on this Friday, wrapping up another great week with Gary Fogle. We'll have more Monday. It's 7:30.
Happy birthday!
WCLU's Good Morning Live, celebrating your birthdays and anniversaries.
Yes, we are today and the weekend, too. On this Friday, April 12th, we have Lorraine Jones celebrating. Francis Lee, happy birthday to you today. Teresa White is 52. Happy birthday to John Michael Newberry. Brenda Pierce. We have Brenda Walker Russell, who is 63 today, Mandy Elmore, Eric Bragg is big 25, Loretta Davis celebrates today, 2 anniversaries, Steve and Nikki Garman, 21 years, and also Lillian and Evelyn Russell, 66 years today. Congratulations. That's a long time to be wed. Saturday the 13th, we have Ralph Riley, Glenna Gardner, Sandra Matthews, Luke Pitcock, happy birthday to you, Heather Wyatt Parsley, Brandy Davis, Roy London, and Jack Turner on Saturday the 13th. And we'll end the weekend Sunday the 14th, Charles Tony Hayes, Carol Flynn, Valerie Stokes, we have Calvin Benjamin, Martha Walden Neal, William Myatt, also Wanda Scott, Betty Richardson will celebrate on Sunday. Jeremy Alexander, grandson, and Mary Coffey, grandmother, both celebrate. Ellery Hayes and Addison Bell Allen. And 1 anniversary on Sunday, Haley and Jeremy Frazier will be celebrating as well. So congratulations to you folks celebrating. Now, good as gold today is Marsha Latira. Marsha Latira, she volunteers at the Cultural Center. She's been handpicked as our good as gold person of the day, so make her feel real good and real special today on this Friday. Her name goes in the hat for our morning drawing this morning just before 8 o'clock, which will be here before you know it. Big Little Taste of Texas drawing. Be listening for that. 651-914-800-956-1023. Give us a call. We'll add you to the list if you're celebrating today. Visit our website, WCLUradio.com. Nominate someone in your life to be a good as gold person of the day. You can do that right there on the website. 732 on this Friday.
Been longing to spruce up your home with a fresh coat of paint? Get it done and save on Valspar paint at Glasgow Building Supply. You'll get up to $75 back on your favorite Valspar paints during our spring rebate event. Now through April 21st, choose Valspar Accolade Interior Paint and save $15 per gallon. Find colorful savings on other great Valspar paints too. Now through April 21st at Glasgow Building Supply on the bypass. See the rebate URL in store for more details.
Highland Pharmacy on Rogers Road in Glasgow has been a community favorite since 2012, and there's a reason for that. They consistently offer a wide range of customized services, quality care, and a commitment to you.
Highland's MedSync program aligns all your medications to be picked up at the same time each month. Free COVID tests are available through some insurance carriers, and Highland Pharmacy accepts most all insurance. Plus fast, friendly customer service and free citywide delivery.
Highland Pharmacy, a community favorite since 2012.
Hi, Bill Gaither here, inviting you to join me and all of my homecoming friends every week for some great gospel music that will make your day. We will bring you hope, joy, and encouragement as we play the best of the best in gospel music. So don't miss 60 minutes of the kind of music that you love. We play it every week on Homecoming Radio.
Join Bill Gaither and friends this Sunday at 11 o'clock for Homecoming Radio on WCLU. We are your home for local.
Hey, pet parents. With Progressive's collision coverage, you get extra protection for your cat or dog, because there's nothing worse than seeing your pet hurt.
Like when you see their face after accidentally stepping on their tail, and you say, "I'm so sorry, Mr. Pickles." But as you kiss his nose and rub his little belly welly, you know Mr. Pickles is thinking, "You betrayed me."
Anywho, Progressive pays up to $1,000 in vet bills if your pet is injured in an auto accident. Learn more at Progressive.com and watch where you step. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Collision coverage subject to policy terms. Not available in all states.
Give the star in your life the brightest gift in the world. Name a star after them. This is Rocky Moselle with International Star Registry. For $59 and a call to 800-282-3333 or visit starregistry.com, you can name a star for birthdays, weddings, or even memorials. Over 45 years, we have named millions of stars for celebrities and individuals from around the world. The star you name will be recorded in book form in the U.S. Copyright Office. Visit starregistry.com or call 800-282-3333.
Good morning, live on this Friday. Good morning to you. James Coates with you. We have a special guest with us today. We'd like to welcome Ashley Reynolds to Good Morning Live. And hello and good morning to you.
Good morning.
How you doing today?
I'm great. How are you?
Wonderful. Busy, busy.
Yeah, it's that time of year where spring is sprung.
Oh, I love it. I love it.
Me too.
We wanted to bring you in to talk about a very special event coming up tomorrow, right?
Yes.
Tell us about it.
Yes, it's Dash for Sheldon, presented by Workout Anytime. It's our Kids on the Block free kids run. And we call it Dash for Sheldon because it's in memory of Sheldon Saltzman. He was a man with special needs that passed away a few years ago. And his special needs fell in line with our mission of teaching children the acceptance of differences and disabilities. And we're just so thankful that the community has embraced this event. It's free. Every child gets a free dry fit shirt, goodie bag, finisher's medal. Top finishers get on podiums like they're at the Olympics.
Oh, that's cool.
And then all the money that we raise goes right back into Barron and Hart counties with free Kids on the Block programs. So the counselors, family resource officers, principals, they get to pick their own topics, whether it's mental health, child abuse, cyberbullies. That's what's special. They don't have to wait for a grant to tell them. They can pick whatever their students need.
Sure. Wow. So that's tomorrow. What time do you start tomorrow?
We will be there at 6:30 a.m.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. Oh, well, you're saying that, but you just got to say you get up at 3:30. So that's nothing for you. But we will be there at 6:30. Parents can get there as early as 7:30 to do race registration. Our online is still open, kykob.org. But if you're coming in the morning, you can get your packet in the morning. Kids on the Block program at 8:30. The half K starts at 9, then the 2K and the 3K. So any child 14 and under, even if they're a toddler and they're barely walking, they want to do the half K.
Sure.
This is for all kids. It truly is free. No pitch that day about giving any money. We really would just want kids to get there. So, you know, I always say if there's an issue with transportation, give our office a call and we'll get your kids there.
Right. Dash for Sheldon. The free kids run, sponsored by Workout Anytime here in Glasgow. And where is this going to be held?
Beaver Trail Park.
Okay.
Yeah,
great
my
location.
Favorite park in South Central Kentucky. It's just the most beautiful park that I think in South Central Kentucky. So, yeah, and we've just gotten Kelly McKay will be there helping us MC it. And we just are just so thankful to have strong community support.
Absolutely. you know, it takes a community to, and it's a wonderful thing about this community, how people pull together when there's a need, yeah, and there's a cause.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
We've just had, the business community has just really, really, really embraced this. And I think it's two things. It's a free, truly free kids runs. There's not a lot of just truly free community events that's only for kids. And then the second thing is all the money goes right back into this community. So, you know, we had 32 child abuse disclosures last year. You know, we have our cyberbully program. We're updating our substance abuse script because we've realized a lot of kids, you know, the message used to be don't do drugs. Now, really what kids need to hear is what they can do if they're in situations where they're not being taken care of.
Yeah.
Because, you know, their parents or caretakers are, you know, not able to care for them because they're under the influence. So we're teaching kids what to do if they need to tell somebody, hey, you know, I'm not getting the things I need. You know, I'm not getting, you know, a bed to sleep in or food or to school on time.
Wow.
So powerful stuff.
It is. So do you have kids already registered and signed up?
Yes, we have 85 kids registered, and we're hoping by the end of the day we'll get to 100. So kykob.org, and to, you know, get involved, you know, we love having volunteers. So, you know, we love office volunteers. We love people that just, you know, bring awareness to what we do. And, of course, if anybody wants to be a puppeteer, you know, they can give us a call. But the kids really do believe the puppets are real. I think that's why it's such a popular program. We impacted 41,000 kids in 37 counties last year.
My goodness.
A staff of 8. So we those puppets are rolling and rocking and rolling every day. So
give me that website again.
KYKOB.org.
KYKOB.org for full information there. And again, if you've just joined us, it's Dash for Sheldon, a free kids run sponsored by Workout Anytime right here in Glasgow. And so it's free, like you said. Is there anything they need to wear in particular, or?
Well, just running clothes. And if, you know, a lot of the kids change into the shirt at the race because it's a dry fit, like tech shirt, so it's good for running. It's a really good material for that. So a lot of kids will change to it that day. But no, we'll have snacks and, you know, everything will be ready. And a lot of people tell me their kids are nervous because they, you know, they've never ran a race. You know, they're not on a cross country team. But this, you know, is truly a, you know, just a laid back thing. I mean, it is competitive, but if they cross that finish line, they're going to get the finisher's medal. And the look on those kids' faces when they get that medal, a lot of kids will say, this is the first medal I've ever gotten. But then we award the top finishers because, you know, life is competitive. So we got the podiums, top five male and female with every event. We'll get top. Trophy. So
that's awesome.
Yeah.
All right. And again, kykob.org for information. Ashley, we appreciate you joining
us
this morning.
Thank you so much.
Keep up the great work. You know, it's very important what you're doing.
Kids are everything.
They are.
They are.
They're our future.
Yeah, they're our future. That's it.
Ashley Reynolds with us today here on Good Morning Live.
Hi, this is Jeremiah. And a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A Chicken Minis is that soft roll with that honey butter brushed on it. It's so fluffy, like a cloud. It might be a mini, but it doesn't taste like a mini. That sweet, savory bite and that fluffy roll with that honey butter on it and that crispy chicken, it's an awesome way to start your day, the perfect breakfast treat.
Breakfast starts with Chicken Minis and Simply Orange Juice on the Chick-fil-A app. Real customer paid for their testimonial.
Is reviewing life insurance on your to-do list? Now's the perfect time to add it. A friend recently told me that securing life insurance sooner rather than later can help you lock in lower rates for years to come. So, I bumped this up on my list and got it done. I called SelectQuote and couldn't believe how easy and affordable life insurance is. I'm 40 and got a $500,000 policy for $16 a month. My husband's also 40, and his $500,000 policy was only $18 a month. Plus, with SelectQuote's same-day coverage, there was no medical exam required, and we were covered by the time we hung up. Knowing I have this checked off my list feels amazing, but the peace of mind knowing my family is protected feels even better.
Call SelectQuote at 1-800-280-8787. That's 1-800-280-8787. Or go to SelectQuote.com to get your free quote today. That's 1-800-280-8787. Details on example rate at SelectQuote.com.
Join us Monday through Friday at 8:30 for the Houchins Lucky Name program here at WCLU. We're having a lot of fun playing some great gospel music, too, and giving away free groceries from Houchins. Send us a postcard at P.O. Box 1628, Glasgow, Kentucky, 42142 for a shot at winning. And each morning we draw from that Houchins Lucky Name sack. It's the Houchins Lucky Name program at 8:30 a.m. Monday through Friday at WCLU. WCLU Radio, your home for local. When you download the free WCLU Radio app, you have instant access to local news, obituaries, community events, birthdays and anniversaries, and more. Plus, you can stream our quality audio with one touch of your finger. It's free. It's in your app store. Check it out today and download the WCLU Radio app to your smart device. We're keeping it local with WCLU.
Great job. Next up, we have Samantha.
10 times better performance can make a big difference. Castrol Edge Motor Oil gives your engine 10 times better high temperature performance. Castrol Edge, better oil for maximum performance. Now through April 23rd, get a $15 gift card when you buy 5 or more quarts of Edge or Edge High Mileage Full Synthetic, only at O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Claim based on Sequence 3 H-Test versus API SP test limits.
Good morning live on this fun Friday. Thank you for joining us here. 1490 AM, 103.1 FM. We're at 50 degrees this morning and our high today about 60. So we've got a little ways to go this morning. Matthew Clark joins us up the hall and around the corner. Matthew, if I can get it out, how are you doing today?
I am doing fantastic. James, how are you this morning?
Man, I'm doing okay. I appreciate Ashley for coming in, sharing about this big Run for Kids tomorrow.
Of course, yeah, it sounds like an awesome event. Of course, being hosted kids.
There you go.
On the block. I'll spit it out eventually.
Apostrophe yes. Well, good morning, everybody. And our big drawing coming up here in less than 15 minutes. So let's talk a little bit about local sports, Matthew.
Yeah, of course. Not a lot of local sports going on yesterday, unfortunately, due to more rain in the area. Yeah. But hey, good news is today is supposed to be sunny and hot and perfect.
Not hot.
Baseball
60.
Conditions.
Not hot. It's not 60.
Hey,
is not
I mean,
hot.
I'd say hotter than it has been, okay?
Now, the weekend, mid-70s, it's going to be beautiful.
Well, there you go, yeah.
Okay.
So, not a lot of sports, like I said, that went on yesterday, but we do have one score to report, and that is Glasgow was in baseball action yesterday, unfortunately falling to Bowling Green, a final score 14-4 in 5 innings.
Mm-hmm.
So, like we said a couple days ago, unfortunately, you cannot win them all, and Glasgow falling to Bowling Green. And looking to bounce back as they are on, never mind. They don't play in baseball action tonight. We'll skip that.
Okay. Skip you.
We do have some upcoming baseball and softball games to report for tonight. And that is Barron County playing host to Monroe County tonight. Metcalf County will be on the road against John Hardin. Caverna travels to Warren Central, so that'll be a good game there.
Yep.
Logan County on the road against Warren East. And it'll be Franklin Simpson playing host to Westmoreland, Tennessee. So lots to look forward to in baseball action.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just about the same in softball action, James. Let me tell you, a packed schedule tonight. Barron County playing host to Cumberland County. Clinton County on the road against Glasgow. Hart County will play against Adair County, of course, that being at Hart County.
Yeah.
And Caverna travels to Bullitt Central. That'll be a good one right there.
Mm-hmm.
And your Edmondson County Lady Cats on the road at Whitesville Trinity.
Oh, yeah.
So lots of baseball and softball action tonight and, of course, over the weekend as well. You can stay up to date with all of the sports scores and schedules at our website, of course, WCLUradio.com. Click that sports tab, James. You'll see lots and lots of sports on our website.
Click, click. Yes, sir.
And of course, not only on our website, but you can stay up to date with all cancellations and reschedules by heading to our X on WCLU Radio, of course, formerly Twitter. A lot of people still call it Twitter, but you can visit and stay up to date with all cancellations the second they are announced. So go there, give us a follow there. Follow us on YouTube as well while you're at it, and you can stay up to date with all of our live baseball and softball broadcasts.
Okay. Now, anything else going on in sports you want to mention?
James, I think we can't go by today without mentioning Kentucky hiring or finalizing. I do want to say finalizing a five-year deal with former BYU coach Mark Pope. And looking to take over this Wildcats basketball team, of course, looking at about $5.5 million a year before incentives, so a lot less than Calipari was making, obviously. He is coming in at 51 years old, so that's, you know, to be expected. You know, Kentucky always kind of targets the more experienced, older coaches. I do have a little rundown on him. I did some background research. I'll run through that really quick.
Okay.
9 years of coaching experience for Pope. He spent 4 years coaching Utah Valley, and the last 5 years he's been at BYU. His overall all-time record as a coach, 187-108. Okay. So he does have a winning record. I would like to point that out. Mm-hmm. He was a part of the 1995-96 Kentucky basketball championship team. So he does have that blue blood in him.
Yeah.
And that's pretty exciting, a former Kentucky alumni coming to coach at the University of Kentucky. Of course, with him being at BYU, he did guide the Cougars to the number 6 seed in this season's NCAA tournament, unfortunately falling out in the first round. And James, that's where the negative comes in. He is 0-2 in March Madness.
Wow.
So, you know, not what we're looking for in terms of postseason play, as Calipari's been 0-5, and now we got an 0-2. But hopefully he'll turn it around, because, James, listen to this. Only one season in the past 7 years that he's had less than 20 wins as a coach.
It's going to be interesting to see how that develops, you know.
You know, and a lot of people, it's not the pick a lot of people thought. It's not the flashy name like Dan Hurley or Scott Drew or, you know, Billy Donovan. It's none of those players, and you know, a lot of people were looking forward to that. A lot of people thought, hey, it's going to be this person. It's going to be this person. Nobody thought it was going to be Mark Pope from BYU, but hey, I'll take a former Kentucky alumni to coach this team. He knows the tradition, and he knows it well. So we'll see what happens. Of course, you've got to give him a chance. You can't just roll him out already.
Oh, yeah.
And we'll see what happens with him. But congratulations to him as he finalizes his deal to become the next Kentucky men's basketball coach. And we'll see what happens.
Absolutely. All right. Thank you, Matthew.
Of course.
Now, folks, if I were you, I would head over to the website, click on Best of Barron 2024, and nominate your favorite business in the area. This is the nomination period. Over 100 categories. You got to fill it out. You'll see all the categories there. And then next month we'll have the voting process. And then the next month, the revealing the winners and the awards and the big Best of Barron Bash in June. So, but right now, if there's a favorite restaurant, a favorite doctor, whatever, go to that website and nominate them. Show them you appreciate them. And nominate them. Get them in there.
Well, and James, I mean, we've made it even easier this year than it was last year. And like you said, that Best of Barron Bash coming up June 21st, 5 to 9 p.m., the old French restaurant over there on the way to Cave City. So very convenient for just about everyone in Glasgow.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to be an exciting time. From what I've heard, we're going to have music. We're going to have food. We're going to have a DJ, a live DJ there.
Yay.
So it's going to be lots and lots of fun. But like you said, the nomination period open right now at our website, WCLUradio.com.
Mm-hmm.
Very simple. You put in a little personal information, your first name, last name, email address, click next, fill out a bit of information. You can nominate any time, any day, you know, once per day, per person, per email. But it's going to be lots and lots of fun. Very exciting. Looking forward to it.
Yes, sir. Here's full information on that. So again, WCLUradio.com. And we'll be right back. Take a couple of minutes. We'll come back, chit-chat a little more, and our big drawing coming up this morning.
WCLU, celebrating all the businesses, organizations, and the people that make Barron County a wonderful place to be. It's WCLU's The Best of Barron. Log on to WCLUradio.com and make your nominations in over 100 categories anytime from now until the end of April. Nominees will go into the Best of Barron ballot for your votes in the month of May. Make sure your favorites are represented. The Best of Barron 2024. From your home for local, WCLU.
Good morning, friends. Churches cannot claim to be on a mission with the Father if they are waging war with one another. It's the responsibility of every congregation to do the best they can be. No congregation should measure themselves against another congregation. When any church measures itself against Christ, they will always come up short on perfection. Therefore, we must stop labeling, criticizing, isolating ourselves from, and stop refusing to have fellowship with another just because they do not operate just as we see fit. If God has not made anything a clear statement of right or wrong about a thing or practice, then we have no right to set that definition for ourselves. Many claim to be contending for the faith when in reality they are simply being contentious in the name of faith. We would do well to remember the instructions of Jesus concerning the log in our eye as opposed to the speck in the eye of another. In many cases, the traditional practices and opinions of some have blinded their eyes to the truth and drawn the circle of brotherhood too tight. This is Danny White for the Refuge Church of Christ.
Look sharp for any black tie event or whenever you need to dress to impress. All in Bloom offers a wide variety of brands, styles, and fabrics to choose from, and sizes including big and tall. Come in, get measured, pick your fabric and style, and they take care of every detail, down to the shoes. Choose Michael Kors, Allure Men's, Couture, and Jackson James. Alterations on that new suit if needed. A great selection of bow ties and tuxes are always available to rent at All in Bloom Florist in Glasgow, at the corner of Happy Valley Road and North Ray Street.
Good morning, live on this Friday. The big drawing coming up here in just a little bit. Matthew, you were out yesterday, but yesterday was National James Day.
You know, that sounds like a perfect day for you. I'm sad I missed it.
It was my day.
I feel like you would have been like, the name's Coates. James Coates.
Bond. James Bond.
Hey, I feel like you could play James Bond. Let's be honest.
I'm not physical enough. You got to do more than just walk around and hold a cup of coffee, you know?
Well, there you go. I mean, I feel like it would still work anyway. I don't know.
What are we celebrating on this 12th day?
Yeah, of course, National Days of course, on this Friday, April the 12th, and we have lots to celebrate, kicking it off with National Day of Silence.
Okay, that doesn't work in radio. Okay. You can talk now.
Oh, okay. Good. I had to take my part
he
and
was
celebrate.
Practicing it. Yeah. Okay.
We also celebrate today Big Wind Day.
Okay.
Of course, produced by Big Wind Turbines. So I guess that helps out with lots of powering and much of the same.
I guess so. Okay.
We also celebrate Walk on Your Wild Side Day.
Oh, yeah.
What's that? What is your wild side?
Oh, I think maybe putting some flavored creamer in my coffee. That's a little wild for me.
That is a little wild.
It's just nothing like it. I hardly ever do it, so. Okay.
I know you normally drink your coffee straight.
I do. Straight down.
Well, James, on this April 12th, we also celebrate International Day of Human Space Flight.
Okay.
And with more and more eagerness to explore explore space, I mean, this is a big, big day to celebrate. Yeah.
Okay.
It is also National Only Child Day.
Okay.
We also celebrate two food categories today. The first one I would never take part in. I've tried it. I'm good. I don't want it.
Yeah.
It is National Licorice Day.
I love it.
You love it.
Especially,
you know, I could have guessed that.
The black.
I could have guessed that.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Dip it in your... never mind. Yeah, I love it.
We could talk all day about food here, so we'll go ahead and move on. And, man, this one, a nice bowl of warm soup goes perfect with it. It is National Grilled Cheese Day.
One of my favorite treats in the whole world.
Man, there is nothing better. A nice piece of sandwich bread combined with cheese and butter, and man, what a better way to eat.
Get you a cast iron skillet and you're in business.
There you go. And that rounds out our National Days of course, on this Friday, April 12th. And you can come back on Monday. We'll have even more for you.
Absolutely. All right, 7:56, the drawing straight ahead. Stay with us.
Did you know one of the best investments you can make? It's in yourself. At My Computer Career, in just a few months, you could start your new career in the high-demand, recession-resistant field of information technology. Isn't it time you invest in you and start a career in networking, cybersecurity, AI, or upskill to boost your current IT career? So, get the ROI you deserve at My Computer Computer Career. No experience necessary. Start now at mycomputercareer.edu.
Financial aid is available for qualified students, including the GI Bill.
A look at weather on this Friday here on WCLU. 40% chance of rain, a breezy day, high near 60. Wind gusts today near 34 miles per hour. Tonight, a clear sky, chilly to a low down to 40. A sunny, gorgeous day tomorrow, Saturday, to kick off the weekend, high of 71. It'll be clear 56 Saturday night. Sunday will end the weekend mostly sunny and 77. And on Monday, mostly sunny, beautiful, up to 81. Again today, a few showers, breezy, high near 60, with winds reaching near 34 miles per hour. All right, it's 50 degrees this morning here in Glasgow, WCLU. Three before the top of the hour. Matthew, you have the lucky hat in there. I guess you do.
I do.
Okay. Five names in the hat, our five good as gold folks this week. Draw one out, $20 toward a great meal at A Little Taste of Texas. Mix them up real good.
Oh, I'm mixing them up. Go ahead, give your prediction.
My prediction is Thursday's.
Thursday's good as gold. All right, I'll go with Monday.
Okay, let's see.
We'll see. Here it is, right here.
Okay.
Let's see who it is, if I can get my fingers to open it. It is one of the most deserving people I know, a regular listener. It is Tuesday's Good as Gold, okay. Miss Joanne Hughes.
Hey, there you go, Joanne. Hope you enjoy that meal. Little Taste of Texas.
Of course, a $20 voucher to our friends at A Little Taste of Texas. And James, I know you were there recently.
I was.
I've heard that you enjoyed a nice burger the Texas way. And I wish I could have been there with you. Unfortunately, I had to get some stuff done. But, man, let me tell you, I've been there before, and what a better way to end your weekend.
It's great. Joanne Hughes, our big winner this week. Folks, have a great day. 8 o'clock news coming up. Stay with us all morning here at WCLU.